Now, we're going to get to one of the best bits of working with text in Illustrator. At the moment, I've just typed this normal piece of text here, and as you found before, if you try to colour the text, it will colour successfully as long as they're nice flat colours. But if you try and apply one of these gradients, nothing happens. So it's a little bit limited, the things that you can do with text. It's still editable though, so that's useful. But watch this. I'm just going to copy this. I'm going to press the Alt key and just duplicate this block of text just so you can see the before and after, that's all. Right, with this block now at the bottom, I'm going to do this. I'm going to go to Type and Create Outlines. This is something you'll be using a lot, and as you can see there, it's even got its own shortcut here on the Mac. It's Shift, Command and O, the letter O. So I'll choose that, and if I just deselect now, you can see that there's absolutely no difference really between those two things, but there is a difference. You can't see it. This is normal text, and this is in fact text. Well, it's not text anymore. These are shapes that look like text, and they're very different. If we go to the View menu here and just choose Outline, you can see that the text remains sort of black there, and this is actually shapes that look like text. So they're not editable anymore. You won't be able to change the font or change the spelling now because they're just shapes. But because they're shapes, watch what we can do here. If I get the white arrow, I can select one part of a letter and I can play around with it because they're just shapes, which is absolutely wonderful. You see how we can, using the white arrow here, we can just deal with them just as if they were normal shapes, which of course they are. They're shapes that look like text, and because they're shapes, we can do absolutely anything with them. If we get the black arrow and just select the whole lot, they kind of group together. If I choose, say, this fancy rainbow color, you see here that we can apply the gradient, and the gradient has gone in each individual letter. But if I get the gradient tool and just say stroke along like this, just like you would with any objects, it suddenly sort of treats it as being one object because they're all kind of grouped together, and we can decide how we want to do that like that. So that's pretty wonderful. So that's how you can deal with shapes that look like text.